Beautiful fish, going home. And we'll see what turns up in our burley.
Yo, snappers, up in the burley.
Go on, my son. Yeah, got him.
That's nice there.
Man, that's a fat one, mate.
This is like the meanest streamline fish I've had like ever, bro.
Oh yes, bro. Yes, bro.
Big one.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's the proper one.
Yeah, this is the proper one, mate.
That's a fat one, mate.
So today it's me and Shaw heading out for a good old early morning bait and burley streamlining session. And as we fish today, we're going to be showing you all of the tips and tricks on how we catch our fish. But I'm not going to show you the spots. In fact, it's not so much a spot that we're fishing, but a general area where we've got wind and current running in the same direction.
Been a while since I've done this. Early morning straight line. Need plenty of this stuff here. Get that going before you even worry about rigging up or getting a bait in the water. Just get that burley going. Because once the snapper are here, they'll stay here. If they're here. Okay. So this is where we're rigging up. The next thing is baits. So just taking the backbone out of some of the jackmacks I caught last weekend. Do the old butterfly. But the backbone gets chunked up. And backbone I was taught by a fella, old fella who's no longer with us, taught me a lot about fishing. Because the backbone is the best chunk you can do because of the ammonia that's inside the backbone. As it comes out, it's got a really strong smell underwater to fish. And also being bony, a lot of the smaller fish can't peck away at it, so always chunk up those backbones, particularly kahawai vertebrae, just chunk them up. And you'll find when you catch those bigger snapper, they've got those chunks of bone in their guts. So the old rig's pretty simple here. We've just got the VMC circle hook, and that's it. Bang it through the nose, lob it out, and we'll see what turns up in our burley. I'm just fishing Talica 8. Got some 10kg Suffolk's mono on here. We're in 20 metres of water here, but I've got the burley only 10 metres down, just so it's sort of mid-water. And it can travel a little bit further. And that's the sort of channel that I'm hoping to pick up the fish, because if we get them off the bottom, it means when they grab the bait and they want to get down to that reef that's just out behind us here, we've hopefully got them far enough away that we can stop them. Because it's not overly heavy tackle.
Ooh.
Roll that camera, Shaw.
First bite on the first bait. Tide hasn't really started running yet. Sun's coming up. Yo! Morning streamlining. There we go. That's what came along and ate my jackmack first up. Target species size. Nice snapper. Being the first of the morning, given that I'm feeling real good right now, this one's gonna go back. Beautiful snapper. Tamuri. New Zealand's most iconic fish.
Kia ora, tangaroa. Later, buddy.
Kia. That's how we like to start.
Go on, my son. Yeah.
Got him.
Yeah. First bait snapper. For sure.
Yeah, hard, true.
Yeah.
Another nice little panny, I think.
I'm going to go same again. Straight lining in the morning, yo. Oh, mate.
That's a good fish.
Yo.
Nice.
Yeah. Oh, nice one, buddy.
Ooh.
Yeah, mate, maybe you want to go to a circle hook.
Yeah, I might.
Oh well, that one's coming home. Oh, far out, that's bigger than it felt. Second bait, and another snapper. This is more of the size I like, to be honest, but it's just skinny though, actually, so I'm gonna let it go. That circle hook, eh? It's just, with this mono line, I'm just getting my bites. Slowly tightening up and just winding. And hopefully a big eel will come along. There's a bunch of trevally just turned up in our burley here too, swimming around beside the boat.
So Shaw's rigging up to catch a triv.
Yep, not bad.
Yeah, buddy.
Not a monster, but it's they keep getting bigger like this. Anyway, I'm happy. This is good.
Here he comes. Beautiful.
Beautiful.
With that circle hook, same place every time. Nice.
You catch your trevally, mate, and we can decide whether we're going to sashimi it or use it for a whole bait. I say whole bait. You catch me one of those trevallies, boy.
Yeah, got one.
Good boy. Good boy.
Oh, jeez. It's definitely a trev.
Yeah. I'll get the net for you in a second.
I'm going for the anchor. Not a bad one either.
Ooh, could be a sashimi sizey. Good work, mate.
Yeah.
Targeted.
I mean, that's not a bad trip, eh?
It's a nice one, boy. Nice, bro.
Yodi.
We'll spike him and get him on ice, and then I might just take the head for a
big old bait.
Big old bait.
And that's why, look at that, that circle hook just dropped out. And you can see there, put that hook back, the hole that it's torn. And that's why trevs are hard to catch. Especially when they fight so hard, but you got to use a small hook when they get line shy. So we just drop down to a little wee tiny circle hook here. Nice. Spike him, sashimi, and bait. Yep. And I'm going to use the head for bait. Yep. This one's on that big bait I just chucked out.
Ew.
Turn the remote camera. Yeah. I used one of my old freezer burn Jack Mac sword baits.
Oh, aye.
Yeah, one of the ones I was saving for a sword. Need for next year. See, look, that's the other half of it.
Oh, wow.
Freezer burn, mate. It's got the freezer burn. That's what you need.
That's a nice fish.
Mahin. Yeah. A bit more like it. Yo. Look at that, he's full of those chunks.
Burley's working.
Yeah, Burley's working. He's been eating our chunks this bugger. Same before about chunks of backbone. Look at that. Backbone chunk. Come out of his gob. Oh. There he is. Beautiful fish. Going home. Oh, look at that. Tint. Lighting, please. Lights on. Golden glow.
Another Benny, he's doing some burling for us.
Oh yeah.
Sweet.
Not a red hot bite, but still got over half the tide to run. And as it gets closer to low, I actually prefer it closer to low, to be honest. This here is an eating one. Look at that. All left-handed fish, mate. They're all hooked in the same side of the mouth.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go, shovels. Got him?
Yeah, got him. Oh, no, nice fish.
Good one, boy.
Yeah.
Nice one. Right, and I'm going for the whole ballyhoo. Rig him up just the same. Probably not the best if you're targeting the small and medium fish, but the bigger ones, or even large to medium. Still gonna get that hook in, no worries. Just like that. Oh yes, bro. Yes, bro.
Big one.
Picked up my big bait.
Oh. Oh yeah.
Yeah.
That's bigger, eh?
I think so. Just hasn't started up.
Yeah. Yeah, that's bigger. Oh yeah.
Yeah, that's the proper one.
Good boy.
Yeah, this is the proper one, mate. Not doing anything different, really, from those sort of nice fish we've been getting. Haven't had any small fish at all, eh?
No.
All been good. Nothing even close to undersized.
Nothing under 45 centimetres, really.
But this one's probably a wee bit of a better class of fish, the way it feels. It's just so unfamiliar. I've been so long since I've really been fishing with mono. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I love that feeling, just that thump. There it is, we've got a big colour down there, and it's a good one, hey?
Oh yeah, it's a nice one.
That's sort of getting to the... Thank you, mate, that's beautiful. Right, just leave him in the water, because I'm going to get organised, because I'm going to get a photo of that bugger. You to mark this mean as morning out here with
13 or 14. mean, bro.
Yo.
Wicked.
Yep, it's getting better, eh?
Getting better.
So as this tide starts getting closer to low, that's when I was expecting these better fish. I've got a venting needle if I need to give them a pop too.
Oh yeah, there's plenty over 10 pounds.
Nice fish.
Gave me a good fight, like it.
Yeah.
Man, that's a beauty, isn't it? It's just a beautiful looking fish.
Another left-handed one, eh? Circle hook in the other corner.
That's mean, bro. That's mean.
Oh, gee, he wants to go right.
I'll grab that needle.
Here, bubbles. That's only in 20 metres of water. And you've got to be careful they don't swim off with your needle. That's why I'm holding the needle. So when he decides to go, the needle will pull out and the fish will go away.
There you go, just like that.
Oh, that was quick.
Mm. Yeah, as soon as just a little hollow hypodermic needle. I actually imported about 20,000 of these into the country to give away free for anyone that wants to do the right thing and make sure any fish they release are going to live. Just in shot. Perfect. So we've got the snapper chunked right up now, and look at that, right up, baits is it barely going in, and we've got them up,
yep.
And that one there as well.
This is a nice fish too, I think.
And the rod on it. Yeah, I got him on there as
I've
well.
I've got a little one.
Oh, we're recording on here too, Ming.
I've got a little one on. That was so perfect. Oh, pop mine off.
That's all right, mate. Your dad's still got his.
Smarter.
Oh, I'm snagged, actually. It's gone to ground, the bugger.
Oh, wow.
Swim to ground might have been all right. Can you hold that camera, please, just for a second? Let's see if I can get him out. Swim into the bricks, mate.
Oh, yeah. I might be around you.
Oh. Mate, hard case. So, snapper, we're right up on top in our chunks.
Oh, look at this. Right here, what's a whole massive school? I don't know if it was a snapper or what, something just came up from this burley. Whoa.
Yo, snappers. Up in the burley. Me. Oh.
And right underneath us, yeah, I got picked up just then.
Pretty good, eh?
It. Yeah, for me.
I want to get another bait on. Need to stop filming these snappers now and get another bait on.
Oh, yep.
Good boy. Oh, it looks on the right one too. Oh yeah, goodie.
It's just like the average size, eh?
I know, they're solid, bro. That's a good one, buddy. Things you're not expecting to get when you're stray lining with a chunk.
A nice tataki here. Yeah, boy.
Yeah, boy. He'll have it, just start winding, don't strike. Oh, mate, can't complain to that, bro.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Snappers that I get, they just go nuts on me. They're so nice to you.
You may know how to handle them, boy.
Yep.
That's a good one, mate.
That's a good one.
You want to lift them or do you want me to get the net?
I can get the net. Lift them, probably.
Good work.
Beauty. Ooh. Yeah, take that, bro. Just take it.
Oh. Bugger. Bugger, bugger, bugger. Okay.
You. Yeah. You're fully right about coming into low, eh? The bigger fish.
What do you know? Maybe your old man knows what, old dad knows what he's talking about.
Nah, fluked it.
No complaints with that, mate.
You.
Ah, yeah,
here we go.
Oh, yep. You get him, boy. If it's fat, keep him for your old dad. I like him.
Nah,
skinny. Oh shit, I just got picked up, yo.
Got him.
Yeah, boy.
Doubled up.
Oh, yes.
Stock standard, mate.
Yes, stock standard, mate. Nothing special.
Oh. Doesn't happen very often. So, we'll keep this one too.
Here we go. These are the eaters, boy.
Me? Stuff? Or not?
Yeah.
I got left hanging for a long time.
Oh, don't worry, man, I'll take good care of it. So, Shaw's Trevally you got earlier on. Keep at least a fillet of that for sashimi. But I've got designs on a couple of big baits from it. So they can go back in ready to be filleted and eaten. And then this one, we've two baits. We get the long belly flat one and then we get the big hard top of head. And there we go. That's one bait. Top of head, just all bone. There's no little fish is gonna be able to pick that to pieces. And that's the other bait. And if we get desperate, that'll be the other bait, but still planning on eating that. Bigger bait. Yeah.
Oh shit.
Oh jeez.
Roll that.
Swimming around all over the place, like that it ran that way and then it's come swimming in an arc. It's hard to say how big it is really because of the way it's swimming. I feel like it's got another run in it. Unless it's just that young buck. Young buck going hard. The old strain lining technique, well my own strain lining technique's changed a whole lot over the years. From the big wind up, two hooks, big wind up and strike. So just letting that circle hook roll. I don't want to need a net, bud. You can just wait, boy.
Solid nice. Fish.
Yep. Might just vent him in the net, eh?
Yeah.
Oh no, he's deflated.
Sweet, just let him go in the water.
Yeah.
There he goes.
There he goes. Boom, easy.
Sweet.
Mate.
Oh yeah, good fish. Good oh, fish, yeah. Bro. Good fish, good fish, good fish.
Oh, it's little.
Yeah.
Oh, it's little.
You hear this? Oh, nice fish.
Oh, yeah.
My it's biggest one yet.
Yeah.
Nice, right? Better net the bugger then, eh?
Yeah, solid.
Guide him on over, mate. Oh, yeah. Jeez, he's heavy.
That's fat, eh? Look at that.
It's a fat boy, boy. That's a fat one, mate.
That's like the meanest streamline fish I've had, like, ever, bro. But you know, that's probably the best straight lining I've ever had.
It's been pretty good, alright. So this time here, I'm just letting another ballyhoo down.
Just gonna talk you through the technique.
Oh, Shaw's been picked up. Yeah, I'm hoping I'm gonna get picked up just so I can sort of demonstrate my circle hook straight line technique. You see, I'm just working my spool here. I just like to stay in touch. There we go. It's had a little touch, small fish. And just by adjusting the slack, oh, there we go, picked it up now. I'm just gonna push that drag up slowly and wind. And it loads up, and the hook pulls out every time I try and demonstrate it. Okay, take two. There he goes, he's running with it now. I just tighten up and wind, and it loads up. Just like that with a circle hook, straight lining. And just like every time I go to demonstrate, I pull the hook. Every time! Okay, well Shaw's sorting his fish out, I'm just gonna try and demonstrate this technique. So, a little bit better just grabbed it, hit a jab at it, and I'm just taking the slack up so I can feel what's going on. You can see it's pulling out little bits. Cool, you're right boy, you're right.
Upper cut bro, that'll show on the camera, I just got smoked.
Okay, and I'm just winding tight, whole mackerel, and that's the technique. Yeah, ooh. And every time I demonstrate it, every time.
Oh, geez, man.
I don't know about you and handling fish, eh?
Yeah.
If I turn that camera off, I'll hook it.
Yeah, but then it won't count.
I know. But hang on, I'll do it again.
Oh. Nah.
Let it load up. Wind.
Got it.
No, it's gonna pull. It's gonna pull because the camera's on.
Oh, nah.
There you go. And like I was saying, that's how it's done. Well, that's normally how it goes every time. But for whatever reason, just trying to demonstrate there. Yeah, dropped a few in a row, which honestly doesn't normally happen. Normally the hook just rolls around nicely. There we go. Perhaps a slightly smaller fish, which is why, you know, with the big mackerel, the hookup rate wasn't as good. But nonetheless, still hooked them. I'm going to keep this one because it is a beauty for eating. And there you go, that's how it's done.
Small fish.
Got it that time. Yo! That demo worked. I just had to not say anything. Nice snapper.
See, they're just nice to you.
No, you've got to know how to handle them, mate. You do. Well, she's been a pretty awesome little stray lining session, the outgoing tide. And as I always do, just while I'm having a bit of a scrub up, clean up of the boat, throw out one last big bait. And you'll be surprised the number of times it's caught me a big snapper while I've been scrubbing up. This time though, I'm going to be suiting up, ready to go for a dive, have a look for some scallops. And yeah, I hope you got some valuable tips from just a 3 hour now, 3 hour strain lining session. It's been full on, using a very simple rig. Probably get a few crays and scallops now. But other than that, we'll see you next time at ultimatefishing.tv.
Oh, hello.
That's a big bait.
A big bait.